Welcome to the .NET MAUI Radial Menu Control tutorial. The Syncfusion .NET MAUI Radial Menu Control presents a hierarchical arrangement of menu items within a circular layout, enabling the accommodation of numerous menu items within a given space. In this video, I will show you how to add the .NET MAUI Radial Menu Control to a .NET MAUI application. I will also demonstrate how to add radial menu items, customize the animation speed and position of the radial menu and their appearance, include nested items, and notify when the menu item is tapped. Before you begin, ensure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. After installing the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022. And click Create a new project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the .NET MAUI application and give the project name and location. Next, create a project with the .NET 8.0 framework. Now, the default application is ready to use. Before moving forward, let me take a quick detour to set up the application's environment. I select the Android emulators from this list to see the output in the Pixel 5 emulator. Next, I'll run the application to show you the default output. The application compiles the default code in a few seconds. Now, the application's home page is displayed. Next, let me show you how to incorporate the .NET MAUI Radial Menu Control into this application. I need to install the Syncfusion MAUI Radial Menu NuGet package. So, I open the NuGet Package Manager and switch to the Browse tab. I search for the Syncfusion MAUI Radial Menu package, select it, and install it in my project. After the package is installed, I need to register the handler for the Syncfusion core to map the cross-platform control API to the native view API. I open the MAUI program CS file and add the Syncfusion MAUI core hosting namespace. Then register the Syncfusion core handler by adding the configure Syncfusion core method. Registering a trial license key is necessary to use the Syncfusion MAUI controls. So, I open the AppSAML CS file and add the register license method with the trial license key. To find out where to generate it, please refer to the instructions link in the description below. Next, I navigate to the main page XAML to initialize the control. I remove the default code from the content page section and import the Syncfusion MAUI radial menu namespace. Next, I initialize the radial menu control. Now you can see the radial menu with the center button. Next, I will show you how to add items to the radial menu control. I define the items property. Within this items collection, add a radial menu item instance and set its text to cut. Similarly, include the items copy, paste, crop, and paint. Look, when I tap the center button, you can see the items. Again, tap the button to close the radial menu. To move the radial menu to the place you want, press the center button and drag. You would have observed the center button and rim animation in the previous output when opening and closing the radial menu. To disable the center button animation, set the Enable Center Button Animation to False. Notice that when you tap the center button, the animation is disabled. To decrease the animation speed, set the animation duration to 500 milliseconds. By default, it's set to 200 milliseconds. Before running the application, remove the Enable Center Button Animation property. Checking now, the animation speed is decreased. To programmatically open the radial menu, set the IsOpen property to True. Once the application is loaded, the radial menu is opened without any interaction. Next, let me show you how to position the radial menu at the top. By default, the position is set to 0,0. To To customize it, set the point property to 0,150. Check, the radial menu is positioned at the top. Now I will show you how to customize the appearance of the center button. To adjust its size, set the center button size property to 100. By default, it's set to 56. Customize its radius by setting the center button radius property to 50. It's set to 28 by default. Then, set the center button text to edit. By default, it is set to radial menu. Before running the application, remove the point property. Now you can see that the center button text has been changed to edit and its size increased. To customize the rim size, set the rim radius to 250 and the rim color to an appropriate color. By default, it is set to 300. Look, the rim size and color are customized. Next, I will show you how to add nested items for the radial item. For example, if I tap the paint item, I want to show some colors. To demonstrate this, within the paint item, define the item's property. Then, within the item collection, add radial menu item instances and set the background color. Similarly, add 4 radial menu items with different background colors. Once the application is loaded, I tapped a paint item, and now you can see the 5 colors displayed in the radial menu. In the previous output, you could see the center back button when the paint item was tapped. To customize its text, set the center button back text to back. By default, it's set to submenu. Set font size to 20. Font attributes to bold. And text color to blue. As you can see, the text, color, and size of the center button back are customized. Now I will show you how to notify when the radial menu item is tapped. For the first item, wire the item tapped event with a new event handler method. This event is triggered when you tap the item. Then, navigate to the event handler method and change the method to asynchronous to wait until the alert window is closed. After that, in this method, check if the sender is not null and is radial menu item. If it is, create a new variable, text, set the text from the item, and add the text item is tapped. Next, call the displayAlert method with the first parameter as alert, the second as text, and the third as OK. Then navigate to the main page XAML and wire the item tapped event for the other radial menu items using the same event handler method. Looking here, when I tap any item, you can see the alert message displayed. In this video, you learned how to add a .NET MAUI radial menu control to the .NET MAUI application. I also demonstrated how to add radial menu items, customize the animation speed and position of the radial menu and their appearance, include nested items, and notify when the menu item is tapped. To learn more about radial menu control features, check the documentation link in the description below. I have also included a link to check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.